Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to start with a new great video, how to add storage to two node cluster. This is two node cluster and you can see in storage there are four disks available and we are going to add another fifth disk. To verify, we will go to C drive and go to cluster storage. In cluster storage you can see here three volumes. So after adding another volume you will find volume 4 also available. Let's try to add storage to the server, to the cluster. Click add disk. See, when we click add disk, it shows no disks suitable for cluster disks were found. In order to add disk, first we will go to our storage MSA 2040 and create a new array. This is our storage HP MSA 2040 and we will open browser, use the default IP 10.0.0.3 to log in inside the interface. Username is manage. And password also manage. Sign in. Soon after sign in, you can see there is previously created RAID array, which is RAID 10. There is three RAID arrays, all RAID 10. Two are normal hard drives and the third one is SSD. So now here we will go to provisioning. Before I start this video, I installed 4 HDDs 1.6 TB SSD, sorry, 4 SSDs 1.6 terabyte. So now there is a provisioning wizard, or you can create a virtual disk. We will create a virtual disk. Choose the name, vdisk name. Let's say NVMe SSD. And here you need to choose the level of the RAID. By default, it's RAID 6. You can choose according to your need. If you select RAID 5, you need to select minimum 3 disks to create the array. Once 3 disks selected, you can create the virtual disk. 4 disks you can use as a RAID 5 or you can select as a spare also. So in case your RAID 5 array degrade, you can use the 4 disk to automatically rebuild the array. I need to select here RAID 10. My organization, they need RAID 10 because RAID 10 is little bit faster. So I will choose RAID 10 and here I need to select the number of the disk. RAID 10 require minimum 4 disk. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now we are ready to create virtual disk. Just click on virtual disk, create virtual disk, and also it says assign to. There is two controllers in this MSA. So if you leave it auto, it will automatically assign to any of the controller. You can see here total storage is 6.4 TB. Each hard drive 1.6 TB times 4. But once you create RAID 10 array, it will divide the storage into half. So we will get here 3.2 TB usable disk space. let's create virtual disk. Creating vdisk, this should take a few seconds. Vdisk created successfully. Press OK. Now you can see here we have fourth array ready to deploy. You can see the properties. Health is OK. And current job, it is initializing. Initializing the vdisk, virtual disk, so you can create volume here. It will take some time. You can continue the rest of the procedure while it is initializing. It shows the size of the disk and the RAID 10. While disk initialization in progress, we can continue creating volume. Go to provisioning and create volume. It is asking for the volume name. Volume name is same as vdisk and volume name. You can choose any name. I will choose the same name of the vdisk and volume 1 or partition 1. Then assign the space, how many partitions you want to create. I want to use full space. I want to utilize all the space. So select. You can move the slider also here to choose the space. I want to use full space. And you need to map this volume to multiple host or single host. You need to assign the LUN number also. It's like a partition number. In previous partitions, arrays, I choose LUN 0, LUN 1, LUN 2, and LUN 3. So this time we will choose LUN 4. Then go to apply. It is saying using a default mapping will allow multiple hosts to access this volume. So if you don't want to give access to all the cluster nodes or all the nodes in your environment, don't do this mapping. Map one by one to avoid multiple hosts mounting the volume and causing corruption. Because if you are not having environment with failover cluster, then it can corrupt the volume, can corrupt the data. So make sure you are not going to make volume mapping multiple with multiple hosts. Here I have a cluster software installed, so I will choose yes. I will use the default mapping. Creating volume, this will take a few seconds. Now volume created successfully. Just say OK. Now you can see here, now we have four arrays. So this is, we create the array successfully and we create the LUN and we map the LUN also. Now we will go to the cluster side. So now we are on server side. On the cluster, failover cluster, we will add the disk again. And still it says no disk suitable for cluster disk were found. Let's go to disk management first. Initialize the disk. Disk management. Here you can see I have multiple disks here. Some are already part of the cluster shared volume, CSVFS. And the last disk, it says unknown and offline. So we will click the disk and make it online. Now it says not initialize. Right click and initialize the disk. Choose the master boot plan or GPT, whatever. If your hard drive is more than 2 TB, choose GPT. now it says unallocated. And if you open disk management of another cluster node, you will also find this unallocated disk. Let's go to cluster node 1. Here we can see there is another disk 6 unallocated. So we will not make it online here. Only one node we will initialize and make it online, and all other nodes should see the disk only. You can cross check or verify in other nodes the disk is available in disk management. Let's go back to cluster node 2 and make volume and assign drive later. Right click, new simple volume, click next, choose the partition size which is next, assign the drive later which we are not going to use because we are going to use CSVFS file system cluster storage. Say next, and then allocation unit size, because we are going to store virtual machines here, so instead of choosing default I will choose 64k, which is best for storing virtual machines or huge files, database, video files. And volume label, this is NVMe volume 2, and next, and finish. Now it's formatting and your partition is available, storage is available. Now we need to go to failover cluster. Now once we click the add disk, it will show you the disk immediately. See, it says cluster disk 5 and this is the signature of the disk. If we go to another node of the cluster, like I have cluster 1, and make rescan disk, it will show you disk 6, but it says offline. All the disks cannot be online at the same time, otherwise it will corrupt the data. The disk is offline because of the policy set by administrator. But now if you open failover cluster manager and go to storage, you can add the disk. Add disk. It can be viewed from all the nodes of the cluster. So now we will add the disk. Just say OK. And you can see disk 5 is online. And it says it is formatted NTFS. Formatted by NTFS. Still, you cannot use in the cluster storage. Still, it is showing only 3 disks. The 4 disk is still missing. Now the last option, just right click and add to clustered shared volumes. Once you click clustered shared volumes, now it should be available here in C drive, cluster storage, and volume 4 is available now. It is available on cluster 2 and cluster 1. We will go to the same place in C cluster storage and volume 4. So if you make a file here, you can see the shared file there. Test. Now cluster 1, we will go to cluster 2, we will find the same file here. The volume is shared between all the nodes of the cluster. So this is all for now. I hope you like the video. Please like, share and subscribe. This is end of the video. Thank you so much for watching and giving your valuable time. Thank you once again. Bye.